You're watching UNICEF Television. Telling a story in a 60-second video is a challenge these 20 Mali children were happy to undertake. Over a five-day workshop organized by UNICEF and the 1 Minute Foundation, children from all over Malaysia and various backgrounds had a chance to create, direct, and edit their own video. The workshop was themed Daily Lives and Dreams, which inspired a profusion of ideas amongst participants.
I created a video about environment, you know, about mostly about air pollution, because I don't think the air I breathe and we all breathe is clean enough. So yeah, I'm just trying to do my part to spread the message.
The aim of the workshop is to give children a voice and a platform to artistically express themselves. It is also an opportunity for them to reaffirm their rights in a creative way.
We keep talking about the right to participation, the right to self-expression. These are means and ways which we can use to, in fact, engage with them.
With the guidance of a team of professional video artists and a tint of improvisation, children were able to produce high-quality video pieces that gave them more than just a technical skill.
I believe that getting young people involved in broadcasting also helps in terms of their self-image and their self-worth, making them feel that what they have to say is important enough to be on the air, to be in print, to be in media. And when they feel like the things that they say are important, then they have more confidence to say those things.
Muhammad gained confidence and discovered new ways to communicate with his peers and the world.
Even though I am deaf, during the workshop I felt like I could share my story with others through my video.
Local TV channel, Media Prima Group 8 TV, agreed to broadcast a selection of the videos made by children during the workshop on the International Children's Day of Broadcasting. The workshop is an unforgettable experience for these teenagers, who came with little anticipation of what the outcome would be.
At the beginning of the workshop, I was so scared of filming. Now I think I've achieved something, and I feel good about myself. I am prepared to try new things.
Amidst a multi-ethnic, multicultural, and multilingual society like Malaysia, young people are most susceptible to see their voice and identity contained. Initiatives like the 1MinutesJr reinforces the idea that what they have to say is important and valued. This is Natasha Ikoli reporting for UNICEF Television. Unite for Children.